Hey chess lovers, welcome back to the Chessyard. This is Dhairyabagga, and today I'll be showing you one of the interesting chess games that I played as black side here. Opponent starts with d4 here, I respond with c6. Here comes c4, and I respond with d5. Now opponent can trade off the pawns here, but decides against it and plays a3 instead, preventing any such move in the future like bishop to b4. I went with bishop to g4, preventing pawn forward. And making it hard for queen to develop. Opponent plays knight to c3. And I solidify my center by pushing on to e6. Opponent does take here. I take back with the pawn from e5. Yes, the best move is to take from the c5. But I thought, let me take it from here. Maybe my plan was to castle on the queen side. Here my opponent tries to kick the bishop back. I go with bishop to h5. And now opponent plays bishop on to f4. Trying to make sure that if I develop my dark square bishop onto d6, that can be exchanged up. That's what I do. I also develop my bishop. Open does take. I take back with the queen. And now comes queen to b3 finally, hitting a pawn on b7. Now that can be defended by moving your queen backwards as well. That's what I did here. Opponent plays g4, trying to hit my bishop again. So I just thought I'll go back here, played my bishop onto g6. Open castles, and I played b6 here. The idea was now I want to make sure that the queen is not babysitting the pawn every time here, and I can start moving my queen, maybe give a check from f4 as well. Open plays bishop to g2, and here I give a check, which allows me to grab at least the pawn on f2 eventually, because open saves with the pawn onto e3. I take on a pawn, open takes the center pawn with the idea that after I take, opponent can as well take it. First, I thought I'll take another pawn so that it's a check as well. Opponent defends with the rook. Here I take on the bishop. And after I take, it's simple that your opponent has to take with the queen. And that's what will happen. Opponent will hit my rook as well. And the game looks kind of a draw from there on. But opponent takes on with the knight, which hangs the queen for free. Yes, opponent will get the rook in return. Opponent was planning a fork. Didn't see that it would be a discover attack on the queen as well. I take on the queen, opponent gives a fork, I sidestep, opponent takes on the rook, I come with a check again, opponent sidesteps with the king, and now queen to c6, hitting the rook and the knight both. Now let's go back a few moves. What happened here was, if my opponent here takes with the queen instead, why I was saying it's a draw situation, because I'm about to lose a rook if I don't repeat my moves here. So the only way I can win this game is by repetition. There's always a repetition around in the game. So my idea was to draw the game because that's almost equal rating. And you would take a draw from a situation like this as well. Because after queen comes to e1, opponent has the only move going with the rook backwards. If the opponent decides with the knight backwards, that loses tempo. And the bishop coming to e4 would be nasty because it hits the rook and the queen both at the same time. So moving the knight is not an option. And if you just move the rook once, I can just simply repeat. Opponent cannot go on the light square because bishop controls the diagonal. So the only repetition would happen like this and the game would end as a draw. But instead in the game, my opponent took on with the knight and lose the queen, then wins the rook eventually, but then queen comes in. Fork takes on the knight, opponent pushes with the rook. Here I go with the knight first. Opponent starts pushing. I went ahead with the pawn. And yeah, I just then went on with the game, giving a check eventually, getting the rid of the knight as well. And it was all over from there on because I had a lot of material advantage there. No pawn takes bothered there. I just went on with the knight. Here comes another check and then another with the knight. Opponent does take. I could have taken the queen, the rook as well. I took with the bishop, not with the queen. Could have taken with the queen as well. Then I took on the rook as well. Thought of simplifying the game. And that's what I do here. Just plant my bishop, take another pawn, take another pawn. Plant the bishop again, grab another pawn, defend the pawn, just keep pushing it. And after my opponent went there, here comes the other pawn. I have too many pawns. It's just fun ending eventually. And that's checkmate on queen to g2. So the idea is whenever you are in trouble, try to find out ways to repeat. Try to find a draw out of nowhere. And if that draw doesn't work out, and if your operator is too eager to not have a draw, that can end up in some losing position as well for the operand. I hope it was a good lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. Do let me know your feedback. Keep watching and sharing. Do subscribe to the channel if you haven't already by now. And I shall see you tomorrow with some interesting and instructive content at the same time. Thanks for your time. Take care. Bye-bye.